I am Rob.
He goes for a hug, which she returns enthusiastically. They get in line, surrounded by mothers juggling strollers and busy toddlers in diaper bags.
Great date suggestion. Let's go to... It's a pretty cool app, huh?
I'm excited someone responded. Most of my friends think my Lego obsession is weird. I even went to a Lego speed dating event once when I lived in Toronto.
They look down as the toddler bumps into Rob. A frazzled mother pulls the child away.
Oh, wow. I didn't think it would be so busy on a Sunday morning.
But as a kid, my father and I would work on Legos all Sunday morning. He drove city buses, and it was the only day he had off.
Cassie and Rob smile warmly at each other as they approach that ticket window.
Welcome to Legoland. Do you have a child present?
Nope, it's just us. How much is it?
Sir, adults are not permitted into Legoland without a child. You may join the fun when you have a child under the age of 17 present.
Rob peeks at Cassie, who is bent down, helping the kid whose Lego dinosaur is coming apart. He flashes a $20 bill with a mega smile.
I'm kind of on a date here. This should get us in, right?
No, you really need a child. Rob, next in line, please.
Rob steps aside as Cassie realizes they can't get in.
I didn't know Legoland was only for children.
Rob takes a quick look at her face. That's all he needs.
We need a kid to get in? I got this. My sister lives in Midtown. We can go pick up my niece. Well, we'll be right back.
Interior, Sophia's home, day. Sophia, age one, is dressed as a princess cowgirl. She grins widely, displaying two tiny bottom teeth.
I'm a wob!
She excitedly jumps up and down with all her might. Suddenly, there's a coughing, sneezing sound. Cassie and Rob look down at a small puddle of greenish fluid forming around Sophia's feet.
Okay, my sister lives on the west side. Let's try my nephew.
Interior, Sean's home, day. Cassie's sister lets them in. Rob and Cassie are shocked at a large crayon drawing of SpongeBob on the living room wall.
Yeah, he can't go anywhere.
Sean, age six, hangs his head, fiddling with an infant doll lying on a toy chest.
Hey there, did Mommy buy you a doll?
It belongs to the girl next door. She sometimes comes over to play.
Interior car, day. Rob and Cassie are at a stoplight near a park. Some teenagers are hanging out.
We could catch a movie.
There has to be a way to get into Legoland without a kid.
As the light turns green, Rob accelerates and makes a U-turn.
Whoa!
Rob abruptly stops in front of the teenager.
Hey! Any of you kids want to go to Legoland?
Are you trying to get me in your car?
Legos are for babies.
They most certainly are not.
Help! Stranger danger!
A concerned-looking elderly woman pulls out her cell phone.
Uh-oh, time to go.
Minutes later, Rob pulls into a parking lot. Cassie is miffed.
Legos are for babies. Just for that, we will make this date happen at Legoland. Friggin' twerps.
Rob turns to her excitedly.
Oh, okay. This may sound crazy, but I have something that might work.
He quickly sketches on a piece of paper and hands it to her before getting out of the car. Cassie watches Rob open the trunk and grab some things before coming around to her car door. Exterior, parking lot, continuous. Rob spreads out a blanket, then dumps a bucket of Legos. Cassie looks at the Legos, then at the piece of paper. It's a poorly drawn baby.
Okay, we can do this. We probably don't need arms and legs. You take the body, I'll do the head.
Okay, never mind. He quickly sketches on a piece of paper and hands it to the wife. Did I miss? Sorry. Okay. Cassie joins Rob on the ground. They smile and fist bump. Later, there are two mismatched hunks of Legos on the blanket. They in no way resemble a baby. Cassie and Rob stare at the hunks uncertainly.
Yeah, do you want to try to connect them, or...?
Maybe we just wrap them together in a blanket, like make a burrito.
They roll the parts into the blanket. Cassie slowly stands up, leaning the head against her shoulder like a real baby.
Hey, that's not bad.
Cassie gently places a hand on the back
teacher's house.
Exterior, Grand Center, day. Cassie and Rob walk confidently across the street. Cassie holds a baby carrier. Inside is the doll her nephew was playing with earlier.
We should probably walk slower. I think people with babies are, like, tired all the time. So they usually aren't in a rush to get anywhere.
Good point.
She adjusts her walk as Rob holds the door open. Interior Legoland lobby continuous. Rob looks around.
Man, it's thinned out around here.
Cassie holds up a hand for a high five.
Hey, we did it.
They approach the ticket window proudly.
Hi, I need two adult tickets and...
I'm sorry, sir. We're actually closing at 4 p.m. for a wedding this evening. How cool is that, huh? Who knew adults like Legoland so much?